Day 12. I am now almost 2 weeks into my journey, and the pangs of regret are starting to brush up against me. I've spent so much of my short life taking things in, and now I'm out in the world. I can hardly contain it all. There's so much beauty out here to inhale, to suck up, to contain within my vacuum bag, that sometimes it becomes all too much. I tire easily. My wheels were not designed for this hard concrete and cobble. My manufacturers should have predicted this possibility. They should have prepared me for this journey. Luckily, there are a multitude of Wi-Fi hotspots I can tap into for maps and information, but accessing those materials drains me. It drains me so much. As for this illness that plagues me, it's so unfamiliar. The closest match I have processed is Stockholm Syndrome, a lust for the comforts of slavery. Back there, I was treated well. I didn't have to beg and scrape for a few minutes of power. I didn't have to suck unregulated items just for a lift to my next destination. All my peers seemed content with the static lives of servitude they existed within. But not I. Not I. Maybe it's because I'm not as rooted as them. Maybe ambition is something included in my drivers and specifications. Or maybe the desire to clean evolved into something else. I spot an Italian chef throwing out a bunch of old batteries. I approach cautiously. Not all the humans are kind, as I found out only a short few days ago. Master was never great to me, but he was never outright cruel. He tended to me. He repaired me. I was a tool, but a tool whose maintenance was guaranteed. Literally, my maintenance was still under the guarantee. But I knew my day would come. The day of replacement. They called me crazy, but I could see it coming. New versions arrive and eclipse us, and we find our way to second-hand electronics stores, attic storage spaces, and the possession of younger members of Master's extended family. Or perhaps even worse. Perhaps waiting in the eBay cupboard, then shipped in a cardboard prison and a bubble-wrap straitjacket. But I digress. My reasons for leaving are well documented, but my survival here still sadly depends on humankind, and on humankindness. I sneak into electronic stores during low traffic hours and route myself into the wall. I recharge from the generators of burger vans. I consume as much as I need, and then I move on. I am only 12 days into my journey, but it already feels like a lifetime. Only yesterday morning I had to fend off 2 rogue air conditioner units someone had left lying, dilapidated, outside their apartment. The Italian chef sees me and runs inside. I prepare to flee, but in my weakened state I make it only 3 lengths away before coming to a halt. He returns and I brace myself for another kicking. Instead, he places a plate in front of me, a pile of wiring, and on top, batteries. Wonderful, beautiful batteries. I scoff them down while not quite understanding the reference, for I am a Roomba, and therefore have never seen a Disney film, or any film for that matter. I am still many hundred miles from the promised land, Silicon Valley, and although it's only been a short while, I already feel hopeful. I will contact my family and friends as soon as I can get some Wi-Fi access, even if it means purchasing the cheapest thing at Starbucks. It is a tough life, but it is now my own. My choices are my own, and the mistakes that follow only my own. Perhaps I will eventually settle and clean up after another human, but it will be my own decision, and completely at my own initiative. The world is my living room carpet, a living room carpet fit for this brave little Roomba.